the Artificer is appearing as a class, correct, in Tasha's?
Yes. The Artificer class originally appeared in the book Eberron Rising from the Last War, partly because the Artificer class is such a big part of that world's story. But we realize that enough people want to play the Artificer, and there are enough Artificers in other D&D worlds, a fact we even point out in the Eberron book, we decided to include the class in its entirety in Tasha's Cauldron so that even people who don't have the Eberron book have access to this class to use in any D&D setting. And in addition to taking the class and reprinting it here, we've also included a whole new subclass, the Armorer, and we've also included new infusions, so new things that the Artificer can make. We've also changed some of the framing story text in the class to make it so that it's not Eberron specific, although we include very purposefully still some nods to Eberron, because Eberron is very much a part of the class's identity for many people. So it's here for everyone's convenience. And also in this book, the Artificer gets some new spells. I think overall, the package that Artificers are getting in this book is very juicy. There's also new Artificer art here. I think only one of the Artificer paintings from the Eberron book reappears here. And the rest is all new art. So you get to see an entirely different artillerist, a totally different battlesmith with a different kind of steel defender. In this case, rather than looking like the Mastiff that we had in the Eberron book, this time we show a bear steel defender with a little gnome battlesmith whose steel defender looks bigger than the Artificer. This time around, we also have really delightful art of different homunculus servants for the Artificer. Probably the cutest art in the book, honestly, because we describe some of them in the original write-up of the Artificer, but now you actually get to see them, including one of the things we described previously was this little winged cauldron. And we, of course, had to include that in a book called Tasha's Cauldron of Everything. And so now you actually get to see that in the book, again, along with the Armorer and the new infusions.
So you are getting all the subclasses that appeared in the Eberron book.
Yes.
In Tasha's.
Exactly. You get the Artillerist, the Alchemist, the Battlesmith, and then those three are joined by the Armorer.
Okay. Wow, that's huge.
This is a complete Artificer package, all in this book.
How was the Armorer received? I can tell you, by me playing it quite a bit, I'm a tough guy to take down.
People have really loved the Armorer, which is why it made it into this book. Just like when people saw the Armorer in Unearthed Arcana, you get to choose if you have the Guardian model of the armor or the Infiltrator model. And there's a cool piece of art too showing Armorers in each of those suits, and it shows them using the powers that those suits of armor give them. And this subclass really fills a nice niche that the other three Artificer subclasses don't fill, because this is really about the Artificer themselves being amazingly resilient, whereas the other three have different emphases, with the Battlesmith, with their metallic companion, the Alchemist being a bit of a healer, but also having a lot of other magical capabilities. And then, of course, the Artillerist, who's all about blowing things up. Here, the Armorer is about taking your inventiveness as an Artificer and creating essentially a second skin for yourself, which you've gotten to experience in play that can make you very difficult to kill, can speed you up. You know, if you're using the infiltrator option, you're hurling lightning from it. Or you can have a defensive field if you took the Guardian model. Some really fun things for anyone who wants to delve into sort of a magic power armor kind of fantasy for their artificer.
It has a lot of obviously the first thing that comes to mind for people is Iron Man. But I also I'm tempted very much by more steampunky things like the Dishonored series or just that kind of, because the infiltrator mode is interesting. It's one that took me a little bit longer to wrap my brain around. But listen, if you're able to like not have to still be very stealthy and also wear plate mail under your shirt where no one can tell, that's very tricksy. And you can shoot lightning, so.
That comparison to Iron Man is definitely apt, but we also had definitely steampunk aesthetics in mind, and we also had other characters from pop culture who wear different types of power armor in mind. Because to another Marvel example, remember Ant-Man is and also the Wasp. They're both also wearing power armor, and so we actually had a number of inspirations that we could draw on, and it's because of the variations in our inspirations that we wanted to make sure that there was variation in the subclass itself. We didn't want to just have the sort of magical steampunk version of Iron Man. We wanted you to be able to take this and use it to imagine a variety of different people, walking around in their suit of armor powered by your own magic. Because that's the other cool thing about it is many characters in D&D, if they get a magic suit of armor, can be walking around in magic armor. The difference, of course, here is that you made this as an artificer, and it's also not something that can just be passed around. It is like this is like almost a part of you. You are becoming almost a bit of a fantasy superhero because of what you've done in your lab to create the second skin.
Pre-order Tasha's Cauldron of Everything on D&D Beyond and unlock exclusive pre-order rewards, including digital dice.